Good morning, I'm Francesco Cinquemani, and I'm a movie director, among other things. I made 14 movies in English and zero in Italian. All my career is by accident. All my life is by accident. I started studying electronic engineering because I wanted to be an engineer. To support my study, I started writing. So they offered me the job, and I was pretty successful really young. So when I was 23, they offered the job to be the director of a publisher company. And I said, why not? I never made, I'll try. And it went well. And I had 400 people under me. And after I passed to another publisher company. So my career lasted 20 years. But my secret dreams, from when I was 6 years old, if you were asking to a kid of 6 years old, what do you want to do? I was doing, I want to be an astronaut, a writer, an inventor, and a movie director. Ah. So I made 3 out of 4, missing the astronaut's part. But I don't know, there is still time, maybe, I don't know. Because a friend of mine, there was a TV series for Sky Television, that is national network in Europe, but also in Italy. Friend of mine, an actor, a comedian, said to me, I always wrote, you know, for all my life, and said, they asked me to do a sitcom, comedy sitcom, between cinema and, you know, comedy. You can write because I was a film critic. You know a lot about cinema, you can write this. And they said, but all my stories, people die horribly. Nobody survived in my stories. It was real depressing crime stories, you know. Because I wrote also 3 novels. I said, no, you're funny, you try. I try, and I discovered that I was funny. So it was funny, I made this TV series, I made another TV series in Italy for Rai Television, that is the national network. And it was comedy, 60 episodes for 4 years, all written by me, a nightmare. And I started to write for cinema, but they were destroying my script. I was writing and the director were doing bad job on the movie. So it was a famous Italian actress doing one of my movies. One day on the set, she arrived. I don't tell the name, so she arrived and was talking with the director. That the director was asking me, "What I have to shoot today?" He didn't have an idea what we were shooting okay. Every day. She arrived. He grabbed the director, thrown on the wall, and said, "You are destroying the Francesco script. You don't know nothing about this movie. So from now on, Francesco will direct me." And. The morning after I was on the set directing and I discovered it was not so bad, okay. So I continued. Before I was doing short movies, I was here in Cannes in competition 2001 for Semaine de la Critique. I was in Locarno, I was doing art house. But as everybody in Italy does art house, I said I will be the only one among the really few who does, you know, genre movies because I love genre. So I started to do sci-fi in movies. My first movie officially directed by me because that is the one that I step in, you know? And that was a thriller. After I made the sci-fi, with Alec Baldwin and Danny Glover. Second movie was a heist movie with touch of sci-fi with Antonio Banderas. Third movie, crime like, you know, investigator, private investigator, set in the 70s and the 50s in America with John Travolta, Morgan Freeman, Brendan Fraser. And after something happened to my family because my mother got sick and, you know, everybody was offering me jobs, crime, action, this kind of movies. But my mother was really ill. So I accepted a series of comedy for kids. And also, it happened, you know, the lockdown, etc. So I wanted to do something to the kids of the world. So I've done this series of 7 movies for kids, Christmas and family movies, yeah. Using Baldwin, the 2 of the 4 Baldwin brothers, Alec and Billy. I made five movies with Billy and other two with Ale. The first movie I wrote the script. Okay. They wanted to produce. The producer was Andrea Iervolino and Lady Monica Bacardi. They produced my first movie, Ilbe. The company is called Ilbe. And they produced also the TV the series of The Santa Claus Now for the Americans. They have an American-Italian company. So they offered me a really famous actor. And I said, no, I don't want him. And I said, are you crazy? There was the executive producer, her name is Danielle Maloney. We were fighting every day about everything. And they said, but he's a really talented, a famous actor. And I said, no, I don't want him. Because I knew that for the first movie, this actor that is really talented already made movies, you know, good and not so good, just for the money. So I wanted somebody that he never sold himself, that he made only the movie that was that he believes in. So I had this opportunity to send to, that's a funny story because we grabbed another actor, really important, one of the most important in the world, that he passed a few days here ago here in Cannes, and in a Martin Scorsese movie is this guy, okay? So I don't dare say the name, but you can understand. And he's supposed to be in the movie. We were supposed to shoot in, no, we were shooting in Toronto, in Canada, and he was shooting in New York. He was doing an MGM, another movie. So he was supposed to fly from New York to Toronto to do my movie for that week. But the other movie went late, so they canceled him. And we were without the other actor. So I was shooting with Danny Glover. Danny Glover is another great actor. But we haven't no substitute. So we decided to shoot Danny Glover alone with nobody in front of him, in green screen, you know. And after we'll find the actors. But we didn't know who will be the substitute. And maybe it will be a female. So I changed the script and Danny Glover was talking with the nothing, referring to the other character like Eve or Adam, depending the name. On the set was Stephen Baldwin, because we met him the day before in a party, and Danny Glover invited Stephen to the shooting to see the filming of the movie. At lunch break, Stephen asked, what happened? Why are you doing the double takes and acting alone, talking with them, nothing? We explained the problem with the other actor, and Stephen asked, what do you think it can be good for this role? And I look at him, and I'm really focused when I work. Look at him and said, you are too old, but your brother. And Danny Glover said, yes, your brother, he will be perfect for the role. And said, okay. So Danny Glover and Steven talk with Alec. I asked to my casting director of the movie to send the script to Alec, and the casting director said, are you crazy? It's 20 years that I'm sending script to Alec and he refused. For 20 years, Alec is famous for refuse. So it's more the films that he refused than the movie that he made too. But Alec read the script and so after, without the other actor, we couldn't go forward. So we stopped the production and said, okay, I will go in holiday in Ibiza. And I went to Ibiza in holiday with my girlfriend. So I was in Ibiza one night and Skype of the iPad start ringing. I was the casting director like crazy. He upset it. So it happened like that. And wow. It was a great relationship. And also we are still in touch and we made these other two movies together. So three, and maybe now we have another four.
And even more, Domino, I've lived in this castle for centuries. You would have all the sweets and goodies. You could stay as our guest.
Until when?
Forever.
There is no rule because sometimes it happens, for example, one of the last Alec Baldwin movie that I made is called Billy's Magic World, will be world premiere in Taormina, on 28th of June now. And on ancient Greek theater, beautiful scenario, you know. They screened the movie in real Greek theater. That was written by me with the collaboration of other two people. In other case, they give me a script, especially the American. They work in different way than the European. They have maybe already the script. They submit the script to you. You read the script. If you like, you accept. And I like this kind of difference because it's a way of shooting outside of my mind. Because they are two different jobs. One thing is directing, one thing is writing. When you write, you can do certain things. When you write and you direct, sometimes you close yourself. But if you write something, I can use also your option. But also, when I work with the actor, I'm always, you know, you write the movie several times. First, you write in your head. Second, you write on the computer. Third, you start to do the location and you change the movie because you have the idea, beautiful palms, let's do a scene here. Third, fourth maybe, you meet the actors. Not all the actors are the same. So, and when I write, I think to the character, I never think to the actors because if you never know who will be for sure, unless you build around the character that you're fan. In certain movie, I can do it. The movie that I want, the next movie with Alec, I wrote for him, especially for him. And but when and we are financing here, that's why I'm here for the market. When you meet the actor give you the suggestion, and especially when you have good actor, and I was lucky to work with among the best in the world, they give you a lot. They can see something of the character that you don't see because you think about the whole picture. They live one character. They know better than you the character. And they can give you, not all the time, but they can give you a lot of layers, suggestion, etc. The smart one, okay? And after, when you shoot the movie, you change again because you start the editing. So you have other ideas, maybe something work better, you know. And after you deliver and the distributor change again and destroy the movie. That's the process.
Hello, Billy. What a pleasure to meet you.
You think I still believe in fairy tales?